Hello everyone, and welcome to this webinar where we're going to share a little bit about our 23 roadmap objectives in order to reach our product vision. We have a chat ready also where you can ask questions. I would prefer to kind of go through those at the end of the session. I hope that we have time, or at least we have put in some time in order to get some, to answer some of your questions if you have some of those, but we will actually go through the whole presentation here first. And I think I'll just walk you through what we have of product roadmap objectives for this, for our 23 roadmap. And then also at the end, we'll have a poll and a few things to engage you guys in order for you to have a little bit of an impact of what to see at the end of this webinar. But I'll get to that in just a minute. So let's just get started. A little bit about myself in order to get that out of the way and then focus on the more interesting stuff. I have been in almost a lifetime and building products, which I'm very passionate about. And I've been with that solving complex problems and customer pain points by products with great user experience since I've come from a background of design, where I always had a very high focus on user research and user experience, and being responsible for scaling high performing design and product teams in a few enterprise SaaS companies along my career, which spans for more than 20 years by now. But enough about me. I'll walk you through a little bit about our product vision to get us all on the same page and to start off with that, and then continue into some product objectives that we have in regards to focus and the plans that we have for our 23 roadmap. Some of those five objectives I'll go more into the details about in just a minute, and then we'll end off with a couple of polls where I'd like to engage you guys a little bit more, and then hopefully a demo of some of the stuff or one piece of the parts that I'll be presenting in a minute. Product, I really want us to get on the same page here. And in order to do that, I wanted to explain a little bit about our product vision, which is designing the best innovation experience to help build a better world. Meaning that we have a large focus on an improved user experience for our users in order to faster and more intuitively create challenges, ideas, conversations, and engage with your audience and their audience in order to drive more adoption with the audience of our customers. And to help build a better world, that means our global crowd helps the whole, or helps a lot of the world's largest and most complex businesses in order to successfully innovate and solve global challenges at a scale, which we believe can drive us to help build a better world. Our 23 product objectives, we have defined the following five product objectives that all adheres to our product vision. And I just want to briefly go through them and then later show you some of the examples of what this actually means. So objective number one, advanced analytics and AI. We are to build a platform that enables and encourages customers, partners, and third parties to build on and extend that platform. Number two, self-service at scale. That means enabling organizations to identify solutions to their problems, users to identify problems for their ideas and solutions. And objective number three, engagement at scale. Provide tools and functionality to drive organic and viral engagement and adoption across all user groups. And fourth one, scouting at scale, which is super interesting, and I have a lot more to talk about that also in the later slides. That means providing the tools and functionality to make it easier to segment and target companies and users to engage with. And lastly, but not least, new products. Number five, that means to build or acquire new products and services that drive our Innovation 360 vision. And we have just that, a new product that I want to go in depth with also at the end of this presentation. So that's at least something there to look forward to. Number one, objective number one, advanced analytics and AI. We're doing a multitude of improvements with our analytics and dashboards to drive more adoption and transparency for our users by building a platform that enables and encourages our customers and partners and third parties to build on the platform and extend on it as well. A few key highlights for this is sharing and permissions, meaning that we'll have better report sharing with individuals and groups. For all of you that already work with this, you know how this works. So this is something we hope that you'll be welcoming as well. Also, increased translation capabilities. There's a lot of translations is something we work a lot with, and that also, of course, goes with our advanced analytics and dashboard parts. And then the ability to change ownership of any dashboard that you have. That also leads to improved user experience, which amongst other things is the enhanced implementation of designer versus the end user experience that we have now, and also improved designer support with documentation, with video, with knowledge-based content that we're building out continuously. And also we migrated report builder and analytics content. And then we're introducing a much wider range of dashboard templating for you to use, including widget catalogs, meaning libraries of various widgets, so you can start building more on the whole dashboard elements for you to kind of expand upon. And to support all of this, our data modeling framework with improved support for form fields and additional data points that we're ongoing and continuously kind of improving also and adding to analytics as well. And objective number two, self-service at scale. That means enabling organizations to identify solutions to their problems and users to identify problems for their ideas and solutions. Some of the key highlights for this is that we're reimagining the Challenge Builder experience completely. I'll go through that in details in just a minute. We'll also have a personalized content space with much more personal info and use and templates and stuff that you actually can quicker access and have much more of a personalized experience of the platform and the product as a whole. And then we're working a lot with the Open Innovation Experience also in order to merge Open Innovation Challenge process with standard challenge processes. This is something that we can go more in depth with also here at a later stage. Just to get a little bit more in depth with what the reimagined Challenge Builder experience that we're looking into means for you, is that it will actually make it easier and faster to create challenges. You will have a live preview of your challenge when you're in create mode, so you can see what is actually going on, what does the changes and stuff that I do actually impact, and how does that look to the end users and the solvers that we're sending these challenges out to. Then we'll also have support for video. That's been a request for a long time coming, alongside with the typical image formats that we also already support. So this is in order for you guys to drive more engagement to your challenges, get more solvers and ideas to your challenges, and being able to run more challenges, and also decrease the launch time it takes for you to build and launch challenges going forward. And then also at the end of that, make it easier for you to track the value and the solutions that get implemented on this. Another thing with the Challenge Builder is that we are improving the whole flexibility and customizability. We already have a very customizable platform, but we're increasing this built on a lot of the knowledge that we have learned from the previous years and how our customers are using the platform as it is, or the Challenge Builder also, by having more flexible stage definitions supported by a templating system that we are building alongside with this. and then setting up stages faster and easily with predefined stages or by building your own customized stages, which is some of the part you actually see here on the on this image. And then drag and drop functionality to quickly customize your workflow alongside with that as well. So some of those typical things that you see in a modern SaaS tool as well is something that we're really working towards and implementing, both from a UX perspective, but also UI perspective as well. And then mentioned earlier on the my content space, so that gives you a full overview of the templates that you're building, your drafts and your challenges, or the templates that we have, because we will also provide you with predefined templates built or based on industry-based knowledge alongside with the custom templates that you're also building within your business, of course. And then and we'll also be separating the challenge builder and the challenge launch experience, so you can have this overview in my content space of your drafts going on, and you can then go in and you know challenge launch those challenges at a certain time or a given time that you select also, of course. So that's the whole my content space where you'll have this full overview of your content. Another thing that we're improving on is the integrated form. No more need for leaving the challenge builder and the process of building your challenges in order to create your form. So we have, again, also full customizability directly inside of your workflow when you're building the challenge in order to either use previously designed forms, again, templating systems that we're providing all over the platform, or you can actually edit or have your individual custom forms that you build yourself also. So that is also a huge improvement that we believe in that will make a huge impact for our customers, since the whole challenge builder is a key component, of course, in the whole form and product for us. Objective number three, engagement at scale. This means providing tools and functionality to drive organic and viral engagement and adoption across all user groups. A few key highlights. What we're working on right now is a Microsoft Teams personal app, which will enable access for you to the whole or to the Wazoku platform in order to be able to perform more basic tasks from directly within the Microsoft Teams environment without you needing to log out or log into a website in a browser, but actually stay in the workflow that you're in. In the case, of course, if you use Teams where you normally sit in your daily jobs. And alongside with that, we build on top of that a Microsoft Teams bots where we'll have them enable kind of the user interactions within the Teams environment, so you can interact directly with the bot. You get notification directly inside MS Teams without leaving whatever you're working on or whatever context you're working in. So, and then alongside with that, there's a lot of stuff we're building into functionality and features we're building into the bots, which is something we will also build upon going further down the roadmap. But for us to kind of evaluate, or for you guys to also evaluate and progress ideas, this is something we find really seamless when you're inside MS Teams with a bot, together with that whole interaction that you have with notifications and so forth with Microsoft Teams bots. We want to drive much more deeper engagement and more adoption of your challenges, the challenges that you create, the ideas and the platform in general. So it's generally about being where our users are and making this more of a social experience by driving more communication and more conversations to your challenges and your ideas, and which we do and with this Microsoft Teams integration. Where with the personal app, one thing you can do is, for instance, you will have the ability to search for content, you can view challenges, ideas, you follow content, evaluations, filters, so forth. You can add ideas, add comments, vote, follow content, submit evaluations. There's a lot of the stuff that you can do on the when you log into our platform on the browser, of course, but now you just do directly in a tool that you hopefully sit with on a daily basis also. So that will drive a lot of more engagement, is certainly our hope with this. And also the team spots will also help you with this in order to get the engagement really driven, in order for us to, or you to get notifications, ideas, viewing ideas, commenting on it and voting on them, and all that you already, a lot of the things that you already know from our platform that you can do directly inside of Teams. So that's certainly one of the key drivers right now that we're working on and very excited to launch it. We're talking to several of our customers and having kind of them run on also on a beta trial period with this, and then roll it out at larger scale to everybody by the end of this quarter also. Number four, scouting. Scouting at scale. This is the ability to provide the tools and functionality to make it easier to segment and target companies and users to engage with. What this actually means is that we are starting to capture companies as an entity in order for us to build a database of companies as well as individual belonging to that company or working in that company, which will then lead us to what we call scouting. That means for you as a user or as a company or individual also to scout for companies and individual experts within certain categories or within certain expertises. That means that we'll, by capturing company, what you see here in the screenshot is kind of a company profile page where we capture the companies as a separate entity in order to build this whole database of companies as well as individuals and individuals working within these companies. And then we evaluate and certify the companies in order for more engagement across the whole organization. That means we will also be associating people with skills, with technology, activity, with the parent company that they're working in. So we'll get a lot of data in that will lead us to the actual scouting part, which means that you can then start scouting for companies and individual experts within certain skill sets and categories and what have we, that you can then search and then make sure that you're targeting or you're segmenting the right profiles for your challenges. So you can find the experts within a given field or within a given challenge that you have defined previously. So that means that we'll have a whole activity and knowledge base, statistics, and as we go along, we will create deeper and deeper data on all of the profiles and what it is that they are actually, you know, providing, what it is that they, what solutions they're coming up with, ideas, and all of the data that we can actually attach to profiles and companies as well, in order for you to get a better outcome at the end of your challenges also. So that's something we are super, super excited about also, of course, and it has a huge potential also to build out as we go down the more longer term roadmap discussions also. And then objective number five, new products. Please say hello to something we call Mindpool. As part of the number five or fifth objective is to build and acquire new products and services that drive our Innovation 360 vision. Mindpool was a company that Wazoku bought back in September last year, and we've been working on a deeper integration together with the Wazoku platform and the Mindpool platform, but still we are also continuing the Mindpool platform on a standalone. Let me explain you a little bit more about what Mindpool is. It's an employee engagement and insights collecting tool that is using collective intelligence. It's built for managers in small to medium-sized businesses that are scaling and growing, and it's revealing actionable employee insights and turning them into challenges and ideas, which works by we collect input from respondents by sending out mind pools, typically to employees of your own company. It can also, down the line, we'll look into how can we actually use our external crowd also in order to send out mind pools to and get response back from them. And we'll be processing that, or we are processing that data in real time and automatically, and then presenting those insights that we get at the moment from your employees and your company to take the insights and the actions. We are presenting that to managers, to the board, to the exec teams and so forth. Anyone that is actually is something that is relevant to in the company. And what it actually helps you do is that it discover opportunities and issues within your business, and it can improve your performance and your employee engagement. And then it helps you create the right challenges for your business, because you get a lot of insights from your everybody inside the business in order to kind of get a more clearer picture of what sort of challenges should we start within the company, of course. And the whole idea of Mindpool is really that businesses at the moment miss out on a wealth of knowledge from your employees. And it's not all about engagement. This is knowledge that is directly applicable to your business performance. So it's employee insights across what's relevant for your business and not just engagement. And that is what we believe fits amazingly well with our Wazoku platform, and that we are building deeper and deeper integration for the Mindpool platform alongside the Wazoku platform. But at this point in time, since this is a very new company we acquired, it's a lot of the business that, or a lot of the stuff we're working with in here is actually to get the small to medium sized businesses started with having a lot of insights from the employees, and then we can start building challenges out from that and get into what you all know from what we do in the whole Wazoku product. And you can try it out right now for free. We have a 30-day free trial that you can just go into mindpool.com and sign up if you care to see a little bit more of what it actually is and what it can do for you, and just as what you see here on the video running in the background. And that leads us to all of this collected on a product roadmap. I won't go through all of these individual items. It's more of an overview of what we're working on now, of the things that I just went through, and what is next and what is coming a bit more down the line. And then alongside with this, of course, we're always working on bug fixes, security issues, and general performance and platform improvements throughout the whole product as well. So that was a little bit fast maybe, but at least some of the things that we're working on a high level at the moment, and that I'm hoping that will keep you as excited as we are about it. And to just have you contribute a little bit, we have us joining today. We have two of my very great colleagues, Jimena, who is our user experience designer. We have Christian, who is product manager and mainly driving our Mindpool products. And we would like to have a little poll around which part or which you would want to see a demo of. So either the challenge builder, which I just went through, we have a clickable prototype that Jimena would want to take you through if you for Jimena or the challenge builder. Mindpool, Christian can give you a deeper walkthrough of how Mindpool works and give you some insights of how the product actually looks and works today, if you're also interested in that. Or number three, none of the above, and we can get back to our daily lives, and I'll give you back some more time if you choose that. I'm not sure with the technicalities, Michael, is that... I think there's a poll. I need to get out of the presentation mode here in 1 second. There you go, it's already there. So you should be able to see. I'll just give you all a little bit of time to go through the voting. Wow, that's a clear one. 34 votes at the moment, meaning the challenge builder, Jimena, you're on.
Okay, perfect, thanks. I'll share my screen and can you see it?
Yes.
Okay, thanks. Okay. So I'll walk you through the new designs for the challenge builder. I'll start with one feature that we are adding with these new designs, that is the possibility of creating templates. So the idea is that now when you create a challenge, you don't have to start from scratch every time, but you can choose a template that you already have available so that a lot of things are already set there. So I'll show a little bit of that first. So as today, for example, you can create forms. You also have a part where you'll be able to create templates. And if you go there, you'll have an overview of all the templates that are available in your platform. This is what Flemming showed before. So as he said, we'll provide different templates. So there are going to be different categories there with templates, but you can also create your own template. So here, for example, you have my templates, your drafts, and also the different categories. So if you, for example, want to create a new template for a challenge, then you'll get into the builder. So to create a template, you'll have to complete some of the same steps that to create a challenge. For example, one of them would be the workflow step. As part of this redesign, we're also rethinking the way in which the workflow step works. So we want it to be more flexible and so that everyone can customize it according to their needs. So the idea is that you'll be able to add as many develop or evaluate stages as you want. So for example, if you always have one develop stage and one completed stage, but then if you want, you can add a more evaluate and develop stage. So for example, if you add a one evaluate stage, you'll see everything here. So the first one, for example, that is the develop stage, have here all the settings for that stage. So you can, for example, choose the name that you want or how do you want to develop ideas, for example, by allowing submission of new ideas or only addition of ideas or submission of ideas by teams. And then you'll have the stage settings and the progression settings. So each stage will have a lot of settings so that you can customize, for example, if you want a private comment channel or if you want participants to view other people's ideas or things like that. And then you have the progression settings to choose how you want to progress ideas from one stage to the other, as you do now. So you can, it can be automatically when the stage closes, or you can define specific criteria. Then, for example, if you go to an evaluate stage, you have also the stage settings and the progression settings, but then also you'll be able to choose which evaluation method you want to use in that stage. So you will have, for example, tokens and rating system and pairwise voting and assigned evaluators. If you choose, for example, tokens, you'll have settings specifically for that. So how do you want to call the token? Which icon do you want to use? But if you choose a rating system, you'll have settings for that. So which rating system you want to use, whatever settings you have available. Once you have all the stages that you want in this step, you can go to the next one, where you can choose which form is going to be used in that challenge. So you'll have a list of all the forms like you do now, and you'll be able to preview them all, and whichever you want to select, you can just choose here. As Flemming said, we want to incorporate the form builder within the challenge builder. So if, for example, instead of just selecting this form, you want to edit the form or you want to create a new one, you can also do it here. So this is a list of all the forms that already exist, but if you want to create a new one, you can do it here. And if you want to select a form and edit that one, you can also do it here. So both will take you to the form builder. In this case, because you are editing a form, you have already all the questions that already are there. So for example, you have this text question and this checkbox in this case, and whichever you select, you'll get the settings here. So if you want to change one of the settings, you can do it here. If you want to change the question also, and if you want to add a new question, you can do it here, whichever you choose. Then once all your changes are there, you can save changes and select this form. So then this form is going to be here for this challenge, and you can go to the final step. Here you can add some other things to your challenges. You have these options for now. So for example, you can add recommendations if you want to have ideas recommended for your challenge. That also has some settings here, depending what is enabled. You can add, for example, a challenge specific agreement. It can be like a link, and you have to put the link and everything. And then you can add, for example, also additional languages. If you want to have one default language, but then you also want to add two other more, then you have to provide some of the translations. At any point, you can always save as a draft and you'll get it in the My Draft tab, but then once you're done, you can always create the template. You can add an image if you want to that template, a name, a description. And then once it's done, you create it here in the My Templates tab. I don't know how much time we have, but then I can show this quickly. Once you create a challenge, you'll be able to choose from the available templates. You'll be able to preview what the template has so you know which one you want to choose. And then once you choose a template, you'll have a lot of settings that are already going to be there, but you're still going to have to complete something. So for example, you'll have a general step where you'll be able to choose the name and the description for the challenge and the banner image if you want to add any, and who's going to be the manager for that challenge and some settings, and then any attachment that you want to add. Then when you go to the workflow step, all the stages that are in that template are already going to be there. So then you only have to set, for example, the start date for each stage or who can submit ideas if you want to choose a specific group. And then the same for the form. The form is already going to be there because it's already selected, and you only have to complete some things like the categories that you want to use for that form. The next step, that is the extras, is also already going to be completed because of the template, but you'll be able to add, for example, an award, which specific award do you want to give, and if you have an additional language, you'll be able to provide the translations here. Then we also added here the metrics step, which right now is outside of the challenge builder, so that you can set everything up when you're creating the challenge. So you can put any participation metrics or activity metrics or whichever metric you want to use for your challenge. And then the final step is the dashboard, where you'll be able to see all the available dashboards and choose which one you want to show for your challenge. So if you want to show, for example, one, you'll be able to customize the visibility of the dashboard. So which groups can see the dashboard or which person. And then once you are done, you can choose to see a preview before publishing, where you can see the manager view and also the end user view, which in some cases is not the same. And then you can just publish once you're done. Choose the start dates and then it's there in the platform.
Nice. Thank you, Jimena. Sounds like people are, or seems like people are pretty excited about it as well. So are we. It's really great to get some feedback. We're also running a lot of customer user tests with customers at the moment while we're building this out. Christian, it seems like we also have time to run the Mindpool demo. So people are getting like, it's Christmas Eve. So let's, yeah, we have time. Let's run that through too, if you don't mind, Chris.
Yes, of course. I'm happy to. Great. My name is Christian Charity. I'm a product manager here at Wazoku. I'm also one of the lucky people to have gone over from, you know, in the Mindpool acquire. I'm one of the people who joined Wazoku that way. So as Flemming mentioned before, one thing that we brought with us in this acquire was the Mindpool product, which is primarily a product that focuses on small, medium enterprises. And as Flemming said, at the moment, primarily we focus on the crowd, which is the employees within the organization. Because the reason why the employees in the organization are so important is that they are the people who on the daily life, you know, have all the hand on the dough, as you could say. You know, who knows more than sales and the sales employees who are talking to customers 8 hours a day, or who knows most about the product and what's, you know, what customers want than the customer success people who constantly get feedback from customers. So yeah, it just makes a lot of sense to really tap into this knowledge from employees in your organization about what challenges they see out there and what can be done to enhance performance across a number of categories. So yeah, a super exciting thing that we've done recently is this change. I mean, in the past, every time we got a new customer, there would be a few manual steps related to it. And now in our newest release, we've really taken a deep into automating the whole thing. So as Flemming said, you're able to just go ahead and sign up and get a free trial and get running in just a couple minutes. So today, So today, what I'm going to show you here in this demo is first just how the signup flow looks like. Usually, I wouldn't be showing this because it's just like a signup flow, so it's not super interesting. But if by me spending 1 minute showing this to you, then you will be able to do the exact same thing and actually create an account and get started. So I think it's worth 1 minute extra of your. But yeah, after that, I'll show you just how to create a mind tool and really, you know, how to get started. And then finally, how the insights that you can expect to see, how they look like. Great, so let's go ahead and I will share my screen.
I thought you were just gonna talk your way through the demo.
Exactly, just close your eyes, you know, yeah, imagine a dashboard in front of you. Yeah, perfect. All right, entire screen, there we go. Perfect, so what you see here is that we are on the mindpool.com website. And if you look here, I'm up in the right corner, it says try for free, and that's what we're gonna do. So already now we are basically doing the sign up. I'm just gonna add a little bit of a demo. Here's, there we go. And then click next. So already now an organization has been created. And if I check my email, I have received this email saying, hey, click here to create a password. Wait a second, let me just open this. Great. So here, I'll just add my email again and select a password. And already now, account is created. I'm actually already in the platform doing this onboarding flow. So here, I can add the different departments that there's in my company. I can also in this step already add some email, you know, the email addresses from the different employees that I want to include in this mindful. Typically you would just invite the whole organization, or maybe if you're just trying to test it out, you could test it out just with a few people to feel what it's really all about before you invite the remaining colleagues. And now we are actually already inside of the platform. And so as you can see, it took 1 minute to create this free trial. Now I'm in and I have access to the full platform and all the features. And as if that wasn't great enough, what comes next is even greater, because in just 4 clicks, we go from, you know, having entered the platform the first time to actually selecting which type of mind pool we want to run. So this is what you see here is a list of different ways that we can use depending on what you want to focus on and depending on what value you want to get out of this. We have the business performance, which is our most widely used product because that asks questions across, you know, 10 different categories of performance. You know, how will our sales do? How will our customer satisfaction do? These different questions that revolve around the performance of the overall business. And there are some different ones, but for the sake of the demo, I'm just going to go with this one. And you click next, you see a little overview, you know, what's going to be a part of this mind pool, right? We have our business performance that runs every 3 months. And then in between those months, we have what we call a pulse check, which is just like a single question that asks about how the overall performance of the company is expected to go. So this way, instead of only getting input from employees every third month, you actually get to touch base with them every month in case anything crazy has popped up in the meantime that is worth for employees to share something about. But yeah, we go ahead and click create mindful. And as I mentioned, just in these 4 clicks since we entered the platform, we now have created mind pools that are scheduled for the whole next. And as a matter of fact, the first mind pool here, because I added the start date of today, it's actually already launched. And the different employees that I added in that onboarding step, I just added one, and they have received invitations to participate in this mind pool. So I added just my email, so I would receive this invite. So what you see now is actually what employees get to see, right? So they receive an email saying, hey, we would like to ask you something. And then by opening a link, employees get access to this really nicely looking survey. We support multiple languages as well. So any language you might want, we can add it in there. And then I'm not going to go through the whole flow here of the how the responding to the survey looks like, but I'll just show you a couple of questions so you can see, get a taste for what the what your colleagues and employees of your company would be seeing. And as mentioned, the very first question is what we call the pulse questions. So as you can see, it's a very like high level question about the overall performance of the company. And here they get to predict, you know, do we expect the overall performance to be very bad in the next few months or very everything is going to be really good. So just click there and very good. And then what you see in the next, 10 questions in the specific product, it's about how employees expect performance to be across a number of different areas, right? So how will our company's ability to innovate be in the next few months? So in this case, for example, the employee might say, it's going to be slightly bad. And that has to do with the innovation of existing products or services. Then, depending on what my background is, I might be a salesperson or I might be a product person. And depending on, who's answering, they will have different knowledge based on the work they do in their everyday life at work. So in this case, I might say that our innovation processes are outdated, for example, and we need to create a new strategy for innovation, for example, right? And so basically, what is my prediction based on all my knowledge as an employee? What does this prediction relate to? Why have I predicted this way? And what do I recommend our company to implement to enhance this? And then, we'll have a great impact if we implement it. It won't take much effort. And so the questions go on. There is a total of like 10, 11 questions. So across a bunch of different categories. Instead of answering this whole thing, I'm just going to go ahead and jump to show you how the insights look like on the other side. So I've just logged on to the platform with our demo account where we have a bunch of demo data populated just so you can get a feeling for how those insights look like. So in general, there is like two sections here in the dashboard. And the top section, it revolves mostly around that very first question I asked, right? The pulse question, the overall performance. So here we can see in this latest mind pool that we ran, we can see how, on average across the different departments that answered on how they expect performance to be. So for example, the marketing department, they have quite predictions about how performance will be. So it's somewhere between slightly good and good, they expect performance to be in the next few months. But sales, they have a bit more pessimistic view on it. They think it's going to be slightly bad in the next few months. And also, we can see across over time, different mind pools we've ran, how this performance expectation has developed, right? So it started in December, something like this. Then in general, all departments and the month of January expected performance to be work, and then it kind of got even higher than the first month. So this is, you could say, an executive summary. It's like, okay, what's the current state of employees' expectations of performance? But then when it gets really interesting, it's when we scroll down here to the category stores, where you, across all the different rounds, you can select a specific round and see insights from that specific round. So it has somewhat like an approach where you start in a high level and then you go deeper and deeper, revealing some of these insights and the reasons why things are how they are. And what employees recommend the company to implement to make performance better. So as you can see here, based on the specific mind pool, we can see on the x-axis, we can see the different departments that answered. And on the, you know, on the Y, or, you know, the different rows, we can see what this, these predictions are about. And just as we saw up there, sales is quite pessimistic. So if we try to figure out why is it that sales is so pessimistic about how the sales will go, right? You can actually click here in the heat map, and then the whole dashboard below updates. So we can see that the reason why sales is so pessimistic about how, you know, sales is going to go is primarily because of our pricing and our sales strategy. And if we scroll a bit further down, we can see some very concrete and tangible insights. So the reason why the sales employees are predicting, you know, a low sales performance is because our products are inferior to competition and we're not onboarding new customers. And if we see, you know, how do the employees with their local knowledge, how do they recommend this to take action to enhance this? Here, employees are saying, you know, let's either slash the price or add more features to validate our pricing. Also, let's get better leads or come up with a difference for sales. So this is just a very small that I'm showing you here on how you both get started with Mindpool, get your, you know, yeah, start your Mindpools, inviting your employees, and also how the insights you get in the end, they look like. Starting very high level, how will performance be in general, and thereafter deep diving into specific areas to understand very concretely, you know, what are the areas where we have the biggest challenges and what is the reason why we're having these challenges and what can we do to, you know, kind of solve this challenge. So as Flemming also talked about earlier, the way that the Mindpool product and the Wazoku product really kind of gain synergies is that, you know, currently in the Wazoku product, you know, companies, they just figure out, okay, what challenges do we have? Okay, we have that one challenge. Let's make a challenge about that and find solutions. While, so Mindpool can kind of be serve as an initial step before that, where we say, instead of us just thinking about a challenge and starting that, let's let our employees answer how performance is expected to be across a number of areas so that we in the end get this holistic overview of performance across the whole company. And then we can let this serve as input to what we want to create Wazoku challenges on. And yeah, right now the two products are kind of like separate, but as Flemming mentioned, we're working on integrating them so that this initial step of you know, identifying areas that we can work on and getting this full holistic overview of challenges, that could be an initial step before the Wazoku product that you know today. Yes, so I think that's all I wanted to show you for now. So I will leave you guys to asking any questions if you.
Yeah, amazing. Thank you, Christian. I mean, this is really, thank you for the walkthrough. And I think this, as you just stated, it really leads into some of the issues we have and requests we have from current Wazoku customers. Is the whole part of building the right challenges. What are the challenges we need to build out? And this really gives you the actions to take in order to get to that, which leads me to the questions. We have a couple of questions here. I'll just take them in random order. Robert is asking, do you have any plans to integrate with ChatGPT? Of course, any modern SaaS tool wouldn't be a modern SaaS company without having looked into how you can use ChatGPT. It's something we've played around with, of course, in order to create challenges with help on describing the challenge. There's some stuff we can do there. So we've already done some proof of concepts in that order. But of course, we need to have it in something, some sort of a serious matter where ChatGPT is still also being played around with in a lot of aspects. But I think it can easily help our users also to create challenges faster in order to use ChatGPT in describing and defining them also. the same thing is we're looking into AI and how can we actually, for instance, with all of the data, we get more and more data, we get more and more ideas and a lot of free text, so to speak, that is that you as a challenge manager or admin need to kind of group and categorize and all of that and combine all of those ideas that come in where AI can help us kind of categorize these things for you by looking through all of the text that we got and then figure out what's the kind of the common denominators for all of it and how can we actually put that into boxes so it's more of an easy overview for you to take action on. So those are some of the AI and what we're looking into kind of on a more both short but also long-term roadmap in our data analytics teams. Another question from Des is the Microsoft Teams integration for the creators of the challenges or for the teams of followers or both? It's for both actually. We need to have, it's a lot of the ideas that come in there and the solvers and so that's also, it's very important to drive adoption or engagement with both parties. So of course it's something we're building out for both. Sam is asking, this one is for you, Ximena, will there still be the ability to have multiple forms in the same stage? And those forms appear for users as a single form, I believe so.
Yeah, we're not redoing any functionality in regards with forms.
Exactly.
You're still going to be able to do the same, yeah.
Exactly. So one of our main kind of focus areas also with revamping the challenge builder is of course not to take away some of the features and functionality that you have today, but improve on it and then add functionality also to it, with the main driver being you being able to drive more adoption and engagement by building challenges faster and more intuitively and easily. So that's kind of some of the very important factors for us when we redo this. We don't want to take away or deprecate features that you already have and that you like, but of course we go in and use data to see, are there some features that that are not being used, or are there workarounds for you to come to where you want to go with the product that we can then do in a better way, for instance with the drafts and stuff that Ximena presented in her demo. So that's certainly some of the things that we're looking at. So I hope if we don't have any additional questions, I at least hope you've gotten a little bit of insights to and excitement about what it is that we're building. And I think one more question from Sophie Jellies and said, when do the challenge builder changes come into effect? Oh, thanks. That's something, so we're building, the challenge builder is a huge part of the product. So there's a lot of, and whereas other things we can often like incrementally release stuff, but this has so many dependencies across the form builder, the templates and stuff. So this is something that we are releasing like gradually, but you need all of the elements for that. So that we're certainly working on it in this quarter, and also we'll also be working on it in the next quarter. And with these large projects, it's hard to estimate exactly, or I won't be giving you any dates on exactly when we will have it out, but it's certainly something that is very high on our priority list and something we have a whole full amount or good amount of people working on. Is Wazoku helping for customers to deliver the ideas that has been selected? I'm not quite sure what you mean by that. I'm sorry, but maybe, yeah. We can take that.
Yeah, I mean, I couldn't imagine that it has to do with almost like a consultant work, as in, these are the three ideas we identified, we'll solve our challenge. Now we want Wazoku's help to actually implement it in the organization. I could imagine that that's what they mean.
Yeah, but that's not directly. We're not doing. We have, of course, a huge customer success team that has a lot of experience with that. But at the moment, it's not like built into the platform, so to speak. But of course, a very interesting point and a very interesting thing that we will also look into. What is the kind of the next phase? Just like we with Mindpool are integrating with a kind of earlier stage in the funnel of this whole challenge, building a challenge and creating challenges. And then also, okay, we also need to look into what is then the step further down the funnel, as just mentioned here, right? It's something that we're also looking into, of course, going down the line. Then I want to end up, we have a few minutes, I want to end up with a little, one more poll with what kind of key takeaways you find most interesting from today, because we want to have these webinars on product roadmap going forward also, where we really want to focus on what it is that you guys want to hear and what it is that you are excited about and what it is you want to hear about where we are and what we're building. So I would love to hear your votes on this one before we end in a minute with this webinar. Christian, did you vote for new products or your own stuff?
Absolutely. New product features.
Yeah. Exciting. New product features. Well, let's build more of those and get more into depth with how they actually work and what it is that we're looking into. I just want to emphasize, and again, by ending this off with one of the key part for us focusing on is user experience and lifting our experience to our customers and really getting that to a more simple and beautiful UI that helps you create things faster and without the need of hand-holding or people holding your hands and helping you get through the works and the challenges and whatever you need to do with the product, but really have a highly defined or very strong user experience and the product that you all enjoy to use. So that's the key for us all going forward, alongside with, of course, building the necessary features that you're all asking for also. All right. Thank you, everyone. I think we'll sign off here unless someone have more questions. I think it seems like we are there. Yeah. Thank you, everyone. I'll see you next time then. Have a great day and thank you.